And welcome back here to Rink 2, game number 2 of the day, 2 of 4, back in the D division. We've got the Saskatchewan Viper Kings against Fat Roy. Viper Kings obviously out of Saskatchewan, while Fat Roy are out of Quebec. This is the 2 versus 8 seed, and Fat Roy are the 2 seed as they went undefeated in their preliminary play. Right now, Fat Roy with possession deep in their own zone. They will fling it out, and it will be grabbed by Keaton Slater. Slater up there to Noel. Seth Noel puts it up and in, and Gunther goes to retrieve. But Jadarian couldn't get there. Noel, though, tried to whack it away, gets steered into the corner. And then the ball gets rimmed around to Gunther. Gunther will lift it, and it will be a flooring call, as Noel could not beat that one out, and it will be forced 200 feet the other way, so quick early whistle in this one. Face off one and quickly up here by the Viper Kings. Given away though, but stolen right back. Bogdan. Trying to get through the neutral zone, couldn't, and stolen away. And now here come Fat Roy, yeah, I'm right. Pierce will shoot that one in and it's steered away. That ball scoots all the way by, and Bogdan will have to go retrieve it. Carson Bogdan able to get around. They get it up and out. And that's to his brother Morgan Bogdan. Bogdan gets it over the blue line. Snap right back in from that blue line to Bogdan. Bogdan trying to get around. Passes up to the top. That shot blocked, and into the corner it will go. Noah go out of play, so the faceoff will go into the Fat Roy zone. Face off to the left of Angelo Ekongomakis. And that will be floored by Fat Roy, so the ball will go 200 feet again the other way. Face off again to the left of the goaltender. And around trying to get in there was Slater, but got stopped up. They're trying to whistle for an offside, and I believe they will. Face off one there by the Viper Kings. That one shot in. Fat Roy there to it first in the corner. And they get it up and they get it out. And now here come those white shirts. That ball gets scooted right by Riley Langford Gasmo. That ball just pops out to a defenseman who will bump it out, and they're going to call that a body contact call against Fat Roy. And it will go against the captain, Christopher Fiore, whose jersey's a little off color from the white it's supposed to be. It looks a little more pink than white, so obviously he forgot to wash his whites with his non-whites. So now the first power play of the game will go to Saskatchewan here in the Viper Kings, who have the Palm Squad to our right. Face off one back. Slater, pass it off. That shot blocked. And away will come those Quebec side, and into the zone they'll come. Steered away, and around they'll go. Back into the middle, trying to get a shot away. Won't, and the Viper Kings will come away. That was Carl Gingras there with the opportunity. Dumped in there by the Viper Kings. They're able to pop it up and over. Shot up, and it will be shot long and out. And out to retrieve will go Langford Gasmo. Now looking to dump it in, there will be Carson Bogdan. Bogdan couldn't, at least, actually, pardon me, he did, so I have to now shoot it in. Tipped into the corner. Viper gets their first back in front. That shot, it will go wide. Noel now in the corner. Noel passed into the high slot. That shot from a long way away will be smothered up there. And the faceoff will go to his right. Pardon me, that's his left. seconds left here in the power play for the Purple Shirts, who lose the faceoff but gain back possession. But that pass back was nowhere near Carson Bogdan, who can't retrieve it. So now Langford Gasman's got to go out and get it himself. And now back will come Bogdan with about 10 seconds less than they started with. Bogdan trying to break it in. That one will. So now Bogdan trying to bounce it through two white shirts. Didn't, but we'll retrieve it back. Dumped down deep into the Fat Roy zone. Picked up, passed in front, trying to make it look too pretty. That ball bounced in front. Ball still loose. Viper Kings got possession. Back to 5-on-5. Goalie's now got no stick. That shot from a mile away. It's safe. Back in to rebound. Bouncing around, and it will be smothered finally by Fat Roy. And Tuchuk now in a little conversation there. With Alex Argyrotis. Face off one by Fat Roy, who will get it up and get it out and flying up the floor. That shot right into the chest and smothered by Riley Langford Gasmo. Face off, one back by Fat Roy. It's blocked, and it will go sky high. So that ball will now go back to where it came from. Matthew Coe now to win the faceoff. Loses it. Next, probably that is Jadarian Gunther. Fat Roy now with possession of it, deep in the zone. Passed in front. Fat Roy can get a shot away. Cannot. And the Viper Kings will get away for the second. No, they will not. As it's fired back into the corner. Gingras trying to get it into the middle. Now it is center. That one blocked by Slater, but Fat Roy, though, still with possession. Passed across. Nobody home. And now Gunther with possession. Gunther up for Velasquez. Velasquez gets it, gets the clear. Bounce it back down for Gunther. Gunther into the middle. Could not get it there to Noel. And Noel will have to try to steal that one back. He does get a whack on it, so we'll see if he can get this one back. Still fighting for it. And now Velasquez will retrieve. Velasquez down there for him. Gunther fighting for it. Gunther trying to get around. Gunther goes down. Trying to still get back to it, though. Gunther can't, but Velasquez there to help. Velasquez up top. It's blocked. Velasquez will retrieve. Velasquez trying to get around. And he'll dump it around into the corner. No one saw it, though, with purple, so Noel was late. Viper Kings are able to get it deep in the zone. Stolen though right away, and that is Carson Bogdan. Bogdan able to pass it over, and it gets cleared. Caffett there shoots it. It gets wide and steered into the corner. And now they're going to blow the whistle there as the tie-up was deep inside the Fat Roy zone. So now the face-off will come just to the right as a ton of Women's B players are now starting to file in as the Saskatoon Viper, or the Saskatoon Prairie Storm, pardon me, will start off the Women's B pool playoff as they start against Ontario United at allegedly 12:10 here on Rink 2. Face off one and spun around there, but stolen right back, centered in front, shot, that one saved. Ekonomakis there with a great save. That one gets dumped in. And that one gets sticked down. It's going to be a second minor against Fat Roy. As a way for two or less on the trip, we'll go Joseph Ekonomakis. Guess we'll give a second power play there to the Viper Kings. Face off one. Passed around. Oh, that ball goes right off the face, but it dies right beside the net. Jabbing at it, and... And Tuchuk there gets a couple extra whacks for his trouble, and he puts the hands up like, I didn't do it, officer, and luckily for him, he'll get away scot-free.
I put my first down in a rink, and I don't remember what one it was.
All right, back we go. Tuchuk wins it. Running in, that shot blocked, spun in front, that shot saved away. Ekonomakis has been sharp here for Fat Roy, who again have been dealing with some pressure here from this lower seated side. Passed across, but weren't able to get that cross seam pass, and that ball will get scooted all the way down to Lang for Gazmo. Gazmo will play it up, and now here comes Bogdan. This Viper King side also from Saskatoon, but are listed as the Saskatchewan, unlike the Prairie Storm. That ball shot up and blocked down. That ball trying to get through there for Fatroy. Stolen right though by Carson Bogdan. Bogdan. Fatroy now trying to get it out, and they do. And now Keaton Slater will flip it into the offensive zone. They got about 35 seconds left on this man advantage. Currently 0 for 1 right now are the Purple Shirts. That ball dumped up and right through the legs of Slater, who will ask Langford Gasbo to play it, which he will, but now they're down to about 20 left on the power play. Slater up and tipped in. That was Gunther. Played, blocked by Gunther. Got a whack at it. It will be covered up by Angel Economakis. And lucky for him, because that was a golden chance for the Viper Kings to get on the board. But they got still 11 seconds here on the man advantage with an offensive zone faceoff. So the advantage will stay a little longer than that 11 seconds if they can win the faceoff. Face off one back, and Fatroy will shoot that one right on target. As Langford Gasmo thought about it, looked at the clock, and went, no thank you, I'm going to go back. As Gunther will retrieve. Slater thought about shooting it. That ball gets cleared over. That shot from Milo A. Steered away. That rebound block. Rebound again. That button goes wide on the backhand there for Joey Velasquez. Velasquez, though, gets it back down into the corner. Around will come the Viper Kings. Fatroy now through the middle, loses a handle on there, was Jim Grassis, but he'll get it back. No free run. Backhander in front, stolen by the defenseman there in Cluz, or that could have been real bad. For the Viper Kings, is sliding into the net binder. There goes a Viper King as he got shoved down. And Bogdan fighting for it. Goes back up to the top, it's blocked, and it will go out of the zone for Fatroy. He'll have to go back to retrieve it, but the Viper Kings will elect to go for a change instead of chasing it down. And now the Fresh Legs will chase it down as that ball is blocked. And up the boards it'll come. And immediately stolen away, though, and the Viper Kings will come back the other way. Reimer shoots it in, and it will be chested and saved by Economakis, and the faceoff will stay in his zone. So far, two rather close quarterfinals here in the D division between the 1 and 8 seed, previously with a 2-1 win for the Brampton Hats off over the Kilbride Selects. And this one so far is nothing-nothing with 3:30 left in this first frame. Face off one, that shot from the slot will be blocked and skied, so the face off will stay in the Fatroy zone. Jordan Gall there in the high slot trying to get that one on target, just could not get it through all the bodies. And another face-off violation call. So I think Fatroy's going to get their face-off taker kicked out. So we'll try it for a third time. Let's make it a three-piece. Tuchuk loses it again. And Fatroy will rim it around. Schwartz misplays it. And now here come Fatroy as the player had to do some acrobatic leg movements there to keep himself onside. That shot steered away by Langford Gasmo. Chopped that, kept in by Fatroy for the second. Possession, though, did go to the Purple Shirts, and they will look to get it out. Schwartz, thinking about it. He's having a ponder. That ball's lumped up and well out and caught there at the bench of Fatroy, so that faceoff will go back inside the Viper King zone. I do want to mention that this Fat Roy team has been together since 06. So all the way back when I was 4 years old, this team was created. So they have been together for quite a long time. So you can tell by some of the chemistry they've been able to generate, even though no goal has gone up on the board, you can just tell these guys know each other. Unlike the Viper Kings, it only started back in 2017, but are provincial champs of Saskatchewan. That's why they're here. That ball popped up. Fat Roy off the boards. That pass across. Shot from the point. It goes wide. And now that shot, it goes wide as well. And now behind the net. Still fighting for it there is Fat Roy. Back up. That shot blocked. It will scoot into the half boards. Still with possession of the war, Fat Roy. Now in front. That one's smothered up there by Langford. No, it's not, actually. The ball was stuck in front of the net. That shot, it's blocked. Shot again. That one goes wide. Fat Roy dominating the ball possession of the last minute or so. That shot into the corner. They are able to retrieve it, are the White Shirts. And they're going to call a slash off ball here. So we'll see what the exact call is. As they were battling in front of the net, it looks like Corey Stefiak is going to the box for the slash, which will make it a 4 minute major. I'm getting waved up by Pat. By accident, pardon me. So Fat Roy are getting a minor, so it's four each for slashing. So at the end of the day, it will equal out to 5-on-5 like we were playing, but they will be out without those two players for the next 4 minutes. So the last minute, 35, pardon me, in this first period and a little bit into the second period. That shot from the point, it's blocked, and racing after it is Velasquez. Velasquez will win the race. Velasquez centering in front, tipped and wide, it'll go, but another call goes against Fat Roy, so that will make it a 5-on-4 for the third time in favor of the Purple Shirts. Fat Roy not happy about it. And I was told, actually, by, I believe, one of the coaching staff, but someone with the team, regardless, that they are wearing some apparel of Fat Roy, that it is Fat Roy, not Fat Wah. So, thank you for that. We like to get the names right as best we can. And now I believe a timeout will be taken. So, both teams will get a chance here to reset with this minor just about to start. And unless a goal is scored, it will lap over into the second frame, which might be advantageous for the Viper Kings, who have not been able to break through the wall of Angelo Economakis. Face off now, won by Fat Roy, down another man for the third time. Have killed both penalties, however. Tuchuk. Back to Carson Bogdan. Bogdan looking for a pass. Does give it off now. Noel thought about it. Passes it off himself in front and stolen away. And they're just going to force that one to the net minder and say, let's get a face off. Probably smart with only 58 seconds just about left on the clock. And they're going to kick out Tuchuk. The back judges have been quite particular about the faceoff takers here today. We've seen that in the first game between the Hats Off of Brampton and the Kilbride Selects. Brampton coming out 2-1 winners in that one. Backhander kept in and a good shove there. Possession though kept with the Viper Kings. This Fat Roy team likes to play as physical as you can get here in ball hockey. That ball put in the middle. That one palmed away. Pass down to the goal line. Looking for a pass. Trying to lift it and saved away. But out back into the corner it goes. And up at the top it'll go. Bogdan shot. That one blocked. Bogdan though kept possession. Got Tuchuk on the far side. Gives it to Tuchuk. Tuchuk shoots. That one scoots wide. Now Morgan Bogdan. Bogdan shot. That one is saved. And in the netting it will go. And that's been easily their best sequence of play. But still, it results in a goose egg on the scoreboard with about 14 and a half seconds left in this first stanza. Seconds left on the power play. So again, if the Viper Kings are not able to capitalize this last 14 and a half seconds, they will get about 38 seconds left on the man advantage. That ball goes off the top boards, but comes back off hot and not able to capitalize. So, but another penalty going against Fat Roy, and they're going to blow the whistle then. That makes it a 5-on-3 for the last 3.6 seconds-ish left in the clock. But regardless of that, that will mean it's a 5-on-3 coming out of the break, which might be very advantageous to this Viper King squad to get the break, and then a 5-on-3 power play. Right now, they are 0-for-2, almost 0-for-3 with only, again, about 40-ish seconds left on that man advantage of the first one. It will be another two-minute minor against Fat Roy, so the White Shirts are now down two. Body or down two players, but down three bodies with that first four, the first offsetting 4 minute minors that went earlier. And another timeout is taken. It looks like as Fat Roy is making their way to the bench. So I believe the first timeout was taken there by the Viper Kings. That second one was probably taken by Fat Roy as they gladly take a break here. Well, they're penalty killers. And it is body contact the call. Against Fat Roy. We're having a little siesta there in the penalty box. Face off one. Gunther loses his stick but tries to kick it forward, but the second you think would go, the buzzer never went off, but the time is definitely expired, so we'll now go to the break. Kind of an anticlimactic end of that period because the buzzer never ended up going off, but still. A big end there for the Viper Kings to now go up two players. They'll have a 36-second 5-on-3 coming out of the break here at the 2023 CBHA Nationals. And back to action we come here again. 5-on-3 for the first 36 seconds of this second period. And then it'll be 5-on-4 for another about minute and 20. Trying to get through the Viper Kings, and they will. Trying to steer it towards the net was Tuchuk. Couldn't, so it steered around. That shot up, and it will go out. Quickly played up, though, by Langford Gasmo. In the zone it comes, and can Bogdan keep it? He can. 10 seconds now on the 5-on-3. Bogdan, down low. Back to Bogdan, that shot saved away. Back to Bogdan. Back to Tuchuk, Bogdan. Bogdan to the goal line, center for nobody, and away will come the Viper Kings as Fat Roy have a player fresh off the bench coming to harass a little bit. And he'll get away. Into the corner it goes. 2-on-1. Almost came away with it, and the Viper Kings will now gain back possession with about a minute left in the man advantage. Played up now. Backhander to the middle, nobody home, and the Viper Kings are able to retrieve in the opposite corner. Back into that corner. It will scoot all the way to the top, and Bogdan have to take another run. We'll keep it in at that side. Bogdan, down low. Pass down low. Almost a too many men there, but Fat Roy not going to get the call. And now here comes Fat Roy. Competitive front, that shot, it goes high and wide. Pass the ball back to where it came from. 5 seconds left on the power play. That shot, gloved, and that will cover the rest of the minor. So now, we're back to 5-on-5, as we're gonna see here when these 4 minute penalties expire, as Stefiak thought it ended, but obviously he was wrong, as he'll stay in the box for a little bit longer on his 4 minute offsetting minor. Face off one by Fat Roy. Around the top, it'll go. That shot tipped into the corner. Possession now to the purple shirt. They give it right back at the top of the zone. That shot blocked. Rebound. Still open. Rebound against Gibson. Thought he scored, but he missed the net. What an opportunity for Fat Roy, but they just couldn't cash. And now that ball bounced back in, and they'll swat it back to Schwartz. Schwartz for Slater. Keaton Slater will scoop behind his net. Langford Gasol throwing up the hands. They're trying to block the view. That ball bounced around, and Velasquez thought about chasing. He doesn't. Gunther will, though. Now Gunther will go off. Fat Roy stopped up about halfway to their blue line, but they still do have possession, and now they will get out of their own zone. Up the boards it comes, and chopped in. Slater will be the first one there. Slater thought about sending it. He does send it, and it'll be knocked out. And here they come. In a lone shot, that one goes wide. Caffett just could not get that one on target, as Velasquez trying to gain back possession couldn't. Coe. Around the net it will go. Velasquez will have to go retrieve. He won't. Took a wrong angle, and now Coe will have to fight for it again. Coe trying to get through. Can't, and away come Fat Roy. Over the line it will go. Back across it comes. That shot, it goes wide. Had an opening, but couldn't cash. Fat Roy, that shot from a mile away. It goes into the netting, and that might force that shot back to where it came from. And it was not touched, it just skied its way out. As this Fat Roy team, and you can tell, has what is trying to do what they want to do, they just haven't been able to put it on target. Face off one. By the Viper Kings. Up the boards it'll come. Bounced up and out, but caught, and thrown down there by Langford Gasmo. And I do quickly want to mention, I don't think I intro myself that at the beginning. You'd think I would, but always seem to forget to give my crew some credit. So hello everyone, I'm Spencer Byers alongside Pat doing the graphics and Matthew doing the camera. I will mention them throughout if they're able to help me out, as Pat did earlier with the offsetting 4 minute minors, which now are elapsed, so they will both go to their respective benches. Fat Roy, that shot steered away by Langford Gasmo. That shot saved by Langford Gasmo. Rimmed around by Fat Roy. Trying to get it up and out. Dungrass trying to get around. Dungrass trying to center it in front. Couldn't, and ball will be snapped away and caught after. Goes Noel. Will he be able to beat it? He will not. So that ball will come 200 feet the other way. And I want to see some of the 40 times on some of these ball hockey players, because these guys can move. Some of these guys are rapid. Face off now to the right of Langford Gasmo. Face off one, but the whistle will go as Langford saves it regardless. And a violation against the Viper Kings will force us to do a make a redo. Face off one by the Viper Kings and lifted. And again, went to chase. There was Caffett, but Dyson thought better of it when he saw that ball was well in front of him and he had no chance. So we'll bring it back again to the zone. This zone seems to have a lot of action. We had about 7 straight faceoffs in the last game at the end on the other dot, and now we're on this dot with about our 3rd or 4th attempt. That one won back, but poked away there by the Purple Shirts, but they're not able to gain possession just yet. Now centered in front. Chenier tried to put that one on target, couldn't, but is able to keep possession over Fat Roy. That spinning shot, that one saved away there by Langford Gasmo. Rebound shot blocked. That one by Jesse Kluz. Rebound, no shot off the post! Fat Roy just can't seem to buy one here in this quarterfinal as that ball is floored and sent back the other way. They've hit a post, they missed an open net. I mean, they've done just about everything but throw the kitchen sink at Langford Gasmo, and Riley said no, or the post has in that most recent offering. Face off one by the Viper Kings, but harassed immediately by 2 white shirts as the ball might get forced away, and it will. Velasquez jumps it up and out, but that might be another flooring call. It is not, so Noel didn't chase it because I thought it was going to be their 3rd straight flooring call, so all of a sudden, Fat Roy will come back the other way. And you see there Langford Gasmo doing his best Patrick Starr impression, trying to block the assailant. But now away comes the Viper Kings. That shot saved by Fat Roy. That ball shot and steered away, but no one goes to retrieve it. So a misplay there by the netminder. Imagine though, still co-shot. That one saved. Around it'll come. And now the ball gets dumped in. Retrieved by Bogdan. Bogdan up and around for Slater. Slater dumps it up and gets through the legs, but it will go all the way as Velasquez thought about chasing it, but thought better and goes for a change. Fat Roy now into the middle. Wide open. Fat Roy shot. That one goes wide. Now in come the Viper Kings. Ko dumps it off, and right to the goalie it will go. McConnell-Mack is doing a great job there in net is Angelo, as this game is still in a gridlock, nothing to nothing. That pass in the middle, Fatwa with a chance here, passed across again, wide open, shot, that one goes high, but it might have been a save there for Langford, Gasmo, I'm not exactly sure, center to get in front, that one goes high for sure. And now Coe trying to dump it, can't. Pass across, Gingrassis, that pass is saved there as Pantillas with a shot, another one sprawling, and Langford Gasmo has but showing off his flexibility and dexterity with those saves. Face off one by Fat Roy. That ball goes wide. Stopped up against the boards after an awkward bounce. Trying to get a shot towards the net. They do, and just couldn't get that one in the net. There was Fiera. Fiera, that shot. Saved, and into the netting it goes. So the faceoff will stay in the zone, and Langford Gaslow again just nicks it into the netting. Tommy Fiera, number 74, has been all over this floor in the first half of this game or so, with 6:51 left in this second stanza. That shot blocked. Popped up and gloved down, but I thought it got out. It did, so they're gonna have to re-clear. Now they're good. Passed across. Jesse Kluz, the captain, plays it up the middle. O'Bain plays it up. And then come those Viper Kings. Tuchuk trying to get it through. Votes for Tuchuk. Spinning, shooting, saved. Fighting for it there behind the net. Goes Noel. Noel now. Two on two. Noel still had possession of it there for a second, but Noel will lose it and it will go the other way. Up and that might be off, and it is. He takes the shot anyway, and that might take exception here by the Viper Kings as Langford Gasmo said something to him, and I'm not sure he was particularly happy there with that shot after the whistle. As Keaton Slater there said something to him as well, and there actually said something to Slater, who looks at him like he shot at the after a whistle. At least you can let me do his bark a little bit. But now with 5:59 left in the second period, the faceoff will go to the left of Angelo Economakis. And then Fat Roy face-off taker gets kicked out. And now I thought the Viper King kicker might get kicked out, but blocked after the face-off win by the Viper Kings. Passed up, Slater. That shot right into the chest there of Slater. Or pardon me, in Slater into the chest there of Economakis. Passed up, will it get out? It will not, so back in and back into the zone. Still trying to fight for it there, though, are the Viper Kings, so now, that was a heavy collision. I'm not sure if it was actually a collision, but their penalty will be called, so we'll see who it goes against. It goes against Fat Roy. I wasn't sure who made initial contact, but that was one heavy collision. As Costa Frank Udakis goes to sit for two or less, with the Viper Kings on there doing the quick counting in my head. Fifth power play of the day. They're currently 0-4, so they really need to cash one of these in if they want to be able to get by this number two seed. That shot blocked, goes into the corner. Back up to the top, it'll go. Slater shoots it, tipped, scores! Jordan Gall with the tip in front of the net! And we got a 1-0 game in favor of the 7th-seeded Saskatchewan Viper Kings. It took a tip to get by Angelo Economakis, pardon me, but they don't ask you how, they ask you how many. So with 5:24 left in the second period, Fat Roy's got to get themselves now in the offensive zone and get some sort of, not maybe goal, but pressure on Riley Langford-Gaspro, because they have not been able to beat him yet tonight, and not from lack of trying. They've had some great opportunities, missing wide open net, missing a post, missing another good opportunity there on a 2-on-1 just recently. They've had a lot of chances. They need to cash one of these in now, because it's now or never. Velasquez will dump it into the zone. I thought Lucan was going to get in there, but just could not. Knapp plays it back. Almost given away, though. Bogdan might give it away as he went for the chase. Velasquez dumps it up and out. Gunther going to retrieve it. Derek Lucan trying to get through there. Knapp trying to pass it through, couldn't. And now Carson Bogdan will go down. Carson Bogdan gives it away. Gingras behind the net, trying to center it, could not. And it will be tipped up and be retrieved there by a purple shirt as Velasquez goes around. And Velasquez might have an edge here. Velasquez in alone, backhander. Velasquez, save, batted and caught there by Economakis, but that, from my angle, was an awkward bounce up, but obviously it just got sticked up into the glove there of Angelo Economakis, but a face-off went out good to his left. It looks like another penalty. Two penalties were called. I'm not sure what just happened, but I look down to grab my water and mark up my sheet. I look up, I see two Fat Roys in the box, and it's going to be a 5-on-3 in favor of the Viper Kings here. I'm not sure what the minors are for, or if they're 4 minutes, or what's going on right now, but timeout now taken by Fat Roy. As, again, I do see two Fat Roy in the box. It will be two minors. We'll hear what the call is from the inner rink. As they're right now announcing the goal, but as I look at Matthew, I don't know what exactly, my cameraman might I add, I don't know exactly what those two minors are for, but regardless, this could be very advantageous for the most recent goal scorers in the Viper Kings, as I finally get one on the power play. They're now 1-for-5. They now have two more, technically, but a 5-on-3 chance for a full 2 minutes to get at least one, maybe two more. They still haven't announced these penalties, so now we're going to figure out here. And that actually does kick out their captain, who gets his third minor as he'll saunter off the floor. Christopher Fiore. So Fiore now is done for the morning. And it might be the end of his tournament here with this game in favor of the Viper Kings. Five on three, full two for the Viper Kings. We'll see if they can get a second, maybe third goal, but that ball won back and fired down towards Langford Gasmo, who is pretty good at passing that puck up the floor. It gets over. Now the 5-on-3 will really commence here. Slater. Across. That shot blocked. Slater palms it down. Back pass for Velasquez. Velasquez. Slater. Slater. Shoots it. High and wide. Rebound shot saved and covered up. There by Economakis. Face off, one back by Fatroy again. And that ball is thumped up and out for the second time. As again, that ball almost got through the legs there of Langford Gasmo, but it's passed up to Keaton Slater. Slater now making his saunter through the neutral zone. Pass over to Velasquez. Velasquez trying to get a hold of it. Velasquez did for the second, but now pressured by two Fatroy. And away they'll come with it, Will Fatroy. Now a one-on-one. Gingras. Shot, scores! Carl Gingras ties it 5-on-3, shorthanded. It all alone and scores past Langford Gasmo. Of all the ways I thought that we're gonna score, I would not have guessed on a 5-on-3, but here we are. Tied 1-1 now with 3:23 left in this second period. And Gingras, from what I hear, has been one of their better players of the tournament and will need to have a good night if they expect to win this game, especially with their captain now done for the day, or at least for this game, is Fior. Now in went Noel, or pardon me, I believe that was Lucan, who got shoved down. And now in for two, Chuck couldn't get away, and now Fatroy might have another chance to break. They don't. But now they go the other way, will the Viper Kings. Two Chuck, got 16 to work here in the power play. Passed across, Bogdan. Bogdan making a walk, Bogdan shot, that's blocked, Bogdan. Back down to the goal line. That shot from an odd angle saved, then just couldn't whack that one in. Power play's about to end. Back down to 5-on-5. That pass across, blocked, and that would be a 2-on-0. It is! Away comes Fatroy, but offside! Oh my goodness! Another golden opportunity for the Whiteshirts, but just could not keep themselves onside. So unlucky there for Fatroy. So that faceoff comes just outside the Viper Kings zone with 2:18 left in this period. The Viper Kings are now 1-for-7 technically on the power play, but not only that, they're now 1-for-7 with a shorthanded goal allowed. So special teams playing a big factor here in this game. And now they're going to kick out the white face-off taker in Fiera. Face-off won there by Fatroy. A little too trigger-happy there with Simon Reimer. Taken away now by Reimer. Reimer into the middle. Gunther. Gunther. Waiting. Waiting. Shoots. Blocked. And into the corner it goes. Back for Gunther. Couldn't get it there. Gunther, though, able to retrieve it, shoot it, and it will go opposite corner. Reimer now trying to retrieve. Couldn't. And away will come Fatroy. Belenosi shoots. That one saved. And Langford gets drilled. And now, I thought there might be some extracurriculars after that one, but both sliding there went Mitchell Schwartz and Lucas Valenos. So we'll see what penalty shake out here as Langford sprawled immediately as he got whacked. Pretty heavily, might I add, there by a couple different players. This might be the eighth minor here for Fatroy, and it will be the eighth minor for Fatroy in this game. The penalties have been a killer for the white side. And actually, pardon me, it was not 11. They're sending 94 there in David Lombardi. Or, pardon me, that is Lombardi. Now they got timeout taken there by the Viper Kings. But that will be a two-minute minor there against Lombardi, who I did not think ran into the net minor laying for Gasmo, but obviously I am mistaken. That one won back, but immediately missed there by the Viper Kings. Slater almost missed his footing, but Slater is able to get away. Minute and a half just about left in this game. Back on the power play are the Viper Kings. Keaton Slater. Over the line it goes. Dumped in by Lucan, but they're going to call it an icing? A flooring, pardon me? I would be correct. Obviously, missed the stick there of Derek Lucan, and they're forcing this face-off 200 feet the other way with a minute and a half left in the period and a minute 42 left in the minor. Fatroy's got one on the shorthanded. We'll see if they can get a second here on the face-off win. They lose it. Tuchuk wins it back to Slater, technically has to saunter towards it. Slater. Up the floor. Slater. Passes it off. Back for Slater. Back for Lucan. Lucan almost misplayed it there. Into the middle now. That shot, Tuchuk blocked. Rebound, fanned on, and away it will go. There by Morgan Brogdon. Brogdon, that shot blocked. Dumped up and not out. Slater. Lucan. For Slater, shot wide, rebound, backhanded, saved, and away it will come. I thought Brogdon saved off an odd angle, and now Fatroy with a chance to run. Fiera, back to Fiera, and just missed him there was Gingras. And the whistle went. I didn't even hear that whistle go, but 17:52 left on the clock here. The faceoff, or the offside is called, so the faceoff will be just outside the Fatroy zone with 17 and a half seconds left in this game. Or in this period, pardon me. Ooh, and they're going to kill off Gunther here, and to take a faceoff will be Stefiak, pardon me. And now they both jump there. Both still jumping. And they're going to blow it dead. Who they got to kick out? They can kick out both, or they're going to come talk to both. Oh, I guess they're calling it an encroachment, which is why they're going to redo it. Face off one by the Viper Kings. And the crowd not happy about that grab, but no call. And it'd be dumped into the Viper Kings zone. We'll see if they can hold it here before the clock will expire. It looks like they will be able to hold it and end the period. The buzzer is not going in this rink now, so we'll see if they can get that fixed for the third period, but that will be the period. Two down, one to go, you'd think, as this game is tied 1-1 after two. We're right back with the third and potentially final period between the Saskatchewan Viper Kings, pardon me, and Fatroy out of Quebec here at the CBHA Nationals 2023 in Mississauga. And welcome back here, and as you just saw, Fat Roy scored just about immediately into this period, which puts them up 2-1. That ball passed around. All right, come Fat Roy again, but they lose it. And now Fat Roy played in their own zone. And that is saved up and stopped by goalie Riley Langford-Gasmo. And the most recent goal scorer, I didn't recognize the name, I didn't recognize the number, it was Jordan Villanosi. So The Villanosi brothers also on this team. Quite a few tandems across this tournament. Now the Viper Kings, who are 0-4-8 on the power play, could really use another one to try to get back on the board. That one sent long, but was touched in the neutral zone, so it's not an icing call. Lucan. Up the floor it'll come. Velasquez. Trying to get through. Can't, but actually ends up with the ball. Tries to center it. Can't. Will get a reach center chance at a Velasquez save. Rebound. Still with Velasquez. Velasquez down low. Gunther shot out of angle. Lucan's got to go retrieve now. And he won't be able to. That ball's bounced high, and it might go. And it does for a flooring call. That ball sent 200 feet the other way, and not happy about it, or Fat Roy. They thought they beat that one out. Face off won by Fat Boy. Or Fat Roy, pardon me. And away they will come, will Fat Roy. Away they'll come. That shot saved there by Langford Gasmo off the miscommunication in the Purple Shirts defense. That ball lifted up and it will go long. Picked up, though, in the offensive zone by the Viper King. Sauced it in front. Tuchuk shot. One-timer. That one saved. Battling there in front of the net. That shot from a mile away. It's blocked. And away they will come, will Fat Roy. Passed over. Put up in the high slot. Tried to get it back down low and could not. And away now they will come. Tuchuk into the middle. Stopped up there by off Caffey, but Tuchuk able to get it back in. Slipping though, went for it, but just could not get enough on it. There was Morgan Brogdon. Passed over. Fat Roy into the middle. That shot, it goes wide. Gingras, who got the first one, couldn't cash that one in. And a penalty's going to be called here. Is it going to be on? Is it... Fat Roy, no, it is not. It is the Viper Kings who will get, I believe that is their first, or no, pardon me, second penalty, but first power play for Fat Roy. It is their first power play because the other one was a offsetting 4-minute minor. Oh, wait, and they're still barking here. I'm not sure what's going on exactly. And Tuchuk will go for the hook. Face off will go to left there of Langford Gasmo. Face off won by Fat Roy, and it will be just be a 2-minute minor there to Tuchuk on the hook. Pass across the top. Gingras back to him at the very top of the power play. That shot from the circle is saved, then into the netting it will go, and that's a great block from Carson Bogdan. And now to the right, this face-off will go. That face-off is won and ripped away by the Viper Kings, whose crowd goes wild to our right. And now Fatroy again will come. Around one they'll go. What a move there by Fiera, who will rope his way back to Gingras. Carl Gingras, who got the first marker for Fatroy. Tie this game up at 1-0. Again, this Viper King team was up 1-0 to get the goal scoring started off. In the middle, that shot blocked and fired away again, and the crowd goes wild. Economakis will play it up to Gingras, who will slaunter his way to the neutral zone. Forward there for Fiera, who will make his way over and pass it back to Carl, who doesn't seem to want to take a real run. He'll take a shot from a mile away. That one shot blocked and picked up by Fatroy. Down low, into the middle, scores! Tony Fiera with his first marker of the night. Again, he's been buzzing around the net all night. And he gets his first, and now it is 3-1, and this might be a very tall hill to climb for the Viper Kings. We'll see if the Purple Shirts can get one more, at least, to get this a little bit of a closer game, but if the White Shirts get away with this win, they will move on to the semifinals and guarantee a medal match later. Deep in the offensive zone with the Viper Kings, but they lose possession of it. Raza into the zone. Shot, that one by Raza, it goes wide. And Rand scores! And I believe the goal scorer was for Fatroy, Paul Kaukab. But he ran straight to the passer. So now it is 4-1. And now they're having a little meeting there on the ice. Are the Viper Kings. That's actually Kaukab, pardon me. That shot now steered away. Centered in front, nobody home. And away will come Fatroy. Trying to get it in the zone, they will. Trying to get it towards the net, have not been able to just yet. So now away will come the Viper Kings, who slap it around. And they're able to get away. Caffett will get it in. Wide open shot. Save there by Economakis. Angelo Economakis has been great tonight for Fatroy. He might get the player of the game. And Gingras wanted to call there on a hook, but didn't get the credit. Passed across and stolen right at the blue line. Now here come the Viper Kings. Lucan shot from a mile away, saved and covered by Economakis. Again, coming up next. Now women's B between the Saskatoon Prairie Storm and Ontario United. That base ball passed down. Around it will go, that shot saved. That right now out of the zone they'll come. Have exploded in this third period with three goals. That pass into the middle, that shot saved. Langford, Gasmo, got that one right away. In the corner are the Viper Kings. Trying to get out of their zone now are the Purple Shirts. Round they'll go. Up top, and that one just clears the line, but not by Will there, as Lucan gets around, can't fight for it. That shot, Gunther saved there by Economakis. That one center, trying to shoot it, couldn't get a stick to it. Back in front, Gunther trying to get a whack to it. He'll go down, and nevertheless, here comes Fatroy. And that one's passed and stolen by Velasquez. That shot steered away. Up to Keaton Slater. Keaton. Passed over. Duchuk. For Schwartz. From halfway up the red line. That one got blocked in a way. Fat Roy will come with it. Lombardi will take it back, and Fat Roy are going to come back here and collect. They know they don't need any more. The Viper Kings got to press them. Around the net they're going to go here. Fat Roy went from their own blue line all the way behind the net. And they got 6 minutes to kill. And here they come through the middle. Thought about shooting it, passes it into the slot, and nobody home, and away come the Purple Shirts. Noel. Viper Kings get it up. Can they get it in? They will. Tuchuk fighting for it. Up to the point. Joey Velasquez back down there for Tuchuk, but not able to get it there. Still in their own zone are Fat Roy. They are loving this possession style now up big, and they're just going to pass it around the horn. Because, again, they know they don't need any more. They're just willing to let this one go. Now into the zone they'll come. Fiera deep in the Viper King zone. He loses it. Gets it back. Fiera shot. One goes wide. And now again, Fat Roy. Up they come. Oh, and thrown down there again goes Noel, but no whistle, closest toss. That one blocked, I thought, by Noel, but it will go long, and that will be a flooring call against the White Shirts. And a timeout now taken by Fat Roy with about four to go. The Viper Kings are going to look back at this game and think they were up 1-0. A little over halfway through this game. They got their marker. But they have not been able to add to it, and that has been to their detriment. There's been four unanswered for Fat Roy, three coming just in this period. Whistle goes here. The Viper Kings are still talking. And now they're going to come as they pull the goalie with 4:05 left in this third period. 6-on-5 now for the Viper Kings in the offensive zone faceoff. If they win it, this is a great move. If they lose it, might be up for question. But I guess 5-1-4 run, there ain't much of a difference in the mind of the players. And the ball's not dropped. So now they're sending out both combatants and two new ones come in. And the faceoff is won. Lukin thought about shooting it. Thinks better. That shot high and blocked in front. Trying to get it knocked down. They do. Backhander. That one gets gloved up by Angelo Economakis. So the faceoff win was advantageous. We'll see if they can keep it that way here for the Viper Kings, who will now go to the left of Angelo Economakis, who's had a great game here today. Faceoff won by Fatroy, but lose possession of it. Up the top it goes. That shot saved away. Lukin now. Looking to center, it does it. Pass all the way around the horn. Slater shot, that one's high off the board, tied, and Fatroy gets it steered away into the corner. Tries to get it away though, they can't cap it. It's in the middle, that shot blocked. And mishandled there by Morgan Bogdan as that ball is steered into the Viper King zone and not iced. 3:20 now left in this third period. 6-on-5 right now for the Viper Kings in purple. Through the middle it will go. Chasing. Will go Gall. He's got the only goal for this Viper King side. Gall fighting for it. Couldn't get it, but will steal it away. For the second, however, that ball's limbed around, but Lukin might get there first. I think he did. He did. Centered in front. That one chopped away. Joey Velasquez now. Looking for a pass. He gets it there. Ball loose. Fighting for it. Whacking at it. Trying to get that ball away. And Lukin will retrieve. Lukin can't get that one through, bounced up, and Fatroy will take it away. Opposite boards with no rope back. Dumped up but not out. Velasquez gets it poked off his stick and cleared. So now the line change will come. Slater looking to dump it in. Slater will just take it over. Slater backhands him but gives it away. That ball shot up and iced by Fatroy, so that ball will come 200 feet the other way, and that's been about 2 minutes or so of 6-on-5 action, so it's worked out for the Viper Kings so far. Obviously not on the scoreboard, but they're at least keeping the pressure on this second-seeded squad. Possession right now to the Viper Kings. Stuck up against the boards. Trying to get a hold of it. That ball comes all the way around, and Fatroy's got two white shirts there. Up the boards, blocked by Velasquez for the second, but that ball's popped up, and it will go for another flooring call. So now some barking there inside the Fatroy zone. I'm not sure exactly sure what they're talking about. I assume Christmas cards, but nevertheless, they will now go back to where they came from, which is the faceoff circle. That's Corey Stefiuk. Who is barking with Tony Constantopoulos. That's actually Tony Constantopoulos. Fighting for right now in the corner. And Fatroy's going to get a hand pass, I want to say. No, actually, it will be against the Viper Kings, which means that ball will be forced all the way out. Are they going to put the goalie back in? They are. We'll see if they try to rush him out, though, like they do in lacrosse. I'd look at doors open, so I think he's just going to stick this one out. Faceoff won though by Fatroy, bounced up the boards. Still can't get away, but now they will, and that should be the game, and it is. That is the first and the fifth goal scorer for Fat Roy. David Lombardi gets himself on the board. And that will, if it was not already cemented, it is that Fat Roy will be in the semifinals and fighting for a medal. I think the semifinals will be today, but the medal games will be tomorrow. So do stay tuned for that here for the Quebec side. Ball won there by the Viper Kings, who do not seem to have any interest in pulling out Langford Gasmo, who's got an A on his shirt, by the way. He's not listed on my sheet with an A, but he's got one. Actually, oh, pardon me, he is listed on my sheet with an A, so a goalie's got a number. That's rather rare, very sparsely seen. That ball is floored by Fat Roy, and that ball will come all the way back where it came from. This is Fat Roy's first time here at Nationals, and they have a chance to get themselves promoted to the C division if they're able to come up with the result here today and a couple others later in the tournament. Them and the Brampton Hats off, I think, are going to be two great combatants if they both make it that far. And now away will come Fat Roy. Chenier tried to get through, could not, and kept in the zone there by the Viper Kings. Now Reimer. There to retrieve it. Under a minute to go now in this third period. Fighting for it. There are the Viper Kings. That one centered and through it will go. And all the way it will go with only 38 to go. We'll see if Knapp holds it. Skyler Knapp now with possession. He'll push it forward there to Seth Noel. In comes Lucan. Lucan gets bumped and loses it. And away now will come Fat Roy. As Christopher Gagnon tries to get that one through. Blocked and chopped up, but blocked again. Shot saved there by Langford Gasmo. Poked away. And that should be the game. And that will be the game. And Fat Roy come away. 5-1 winners here. At Rick number two. Fat Roy make it to the semifinals. Both number one and number two are still in this D division. Brampton won just earlier today, and now Fat Roy make it 2-for-2 for the top two seeds. And they will now make it to the semifinals and guarantee themselves a medal game. And they're going to shake hands before they go to blue lines here, as that'll be here for us for the D division on Rick number two. But do stay tuned. Next up, I don't know when, because we are past the alleged start time of 12:10 just. But coming up next is Women's B quarterfinals, I believe, with the Saskatoon Prairie Storm coming up against Ontario United here next. So do stay tuned on Rig 2 at the CBHA Finals here in Mississauga at the Paramount Fine Foods Center, but I prefer the arena.